What's up, gang? So this is the third time that I've uploaded this video. It just continues to glitch. Yesterday I spent all day trying to get it to upload glitch free and to run smooth. The first time I went ahead and made that one private, deleted it. Last night I put it up again. It should still be up. I'm not sure if I'm going to leave it up or take it down. But it was glitching and sticking all the way through to the end, and that was not by intention. So here is the video, hopefully and prayerfully glitch-free for the third and final time. If it glitches this time, I'm not going to do it again. So it is an important video, I believe. But anyways, without further ado, glitch-free, here is the video. Love you guys. Thanks for being patient.
Hello, I'd like to vote for president, governor, and anything that will take money away from our parks and libraries.
Use machine number 3.
Oh, I can't fit in the booth.
Use the double wide.
Ooh, one of those electronic voting dealies.
One vote for McCain. Thank you.
No, I want to vote for Obama.
2 votes for McCain.
Come on, it's time for a change.
3 votes for McCain.
No, no, no!
6 votes for President McCain.
Hey, I only meant one of those votes for McCain. This machine is rigged! Must tell President McCain! This doesn't happen in America. Maybe Ohio, but not in America.
Hey, gang. So the information I'm bringing to you is simply to spur you to think critically and ask, could it be something other than what we've been told? At the end of the day, everything that's being said and any of the information that I'm sharing or the clips, it's up to you and I to research that if it's on our hearts and to determine whether it's valid or not valid. Enjoy watching it, think critically, take what you know is truth, and spit out the rest. So I'm not really convinced that our vote matters. And I've had that feeling for a long time. And there's a lot of different reasons why. I'm not saying that I'm right. It's just how I feel from what I've seen and what I've experienced. It doesn't really matter, I guess, whether you vote or not. And I'm not suggesting that you don't vote. Because I'm pointing out flaws or things that I see that lead me to believe certain ways about political leaders, I'm in no way, shape, or form suggesting that you go and vote for Harris or Biden or whoever they put up there. I think very conservatively. And when I voted, I tended to vote very conservatively. And if I was going to vote, if I believed in it, I would definitely vote for Trump or someone like that. This is not what the video is about. I just believe that America is an oligarchy. It's a coin with 2 sides on it that's held in the pocket of the elite, of one or two people, maybe a handful, but the real power in the world. So, but as far as voting, yeah, if they're still using GEMS and Dominion, and if you believe that the votes are actually tallied and they determine who's the president according to the vote tallies, even if that's how you believe, then you have to question how reliable Dominion is if your vote potentially doesn't even count as one vote. And I remember the first time I heard this, how do they come up with fractions of votes? And I just remember thinking how ludicrous that is, that there are fractions of votes. Let that sink in. You're a fraction of a person if you believe and you go and use these machines. But even if you don't use them, there's plenty of states that are using them. So it's influenced heavily just on that premise. I have ranted and rambled a lot here, so enjoy this video. I haven't fact-checked everything, so here you go. I love you guys. Thanks for listening, and enjoy. God bless y'all.
And one last question. Could you describe fractional voting?
So if all of us in this room, you know, had one vote for one candidate, we would have the sum of the votes in this room. When the votes are reported to from Dominion to the media, they're reported in fractional numbers, three digits. So when you add whole numbers together, you can't get a fraction. When you calculate or have a formula or an algorithm to assign points to votes, then you get a fraction. So our voting results are reported in fractional values, not in whole numbers.
Voters went to the polls to vote on a local county commissioner race in District 2 between Lauren Alexander, Marshall Orson, and Michelle Longspears. The end result from the Dominion machine showed Lauren Alexander received 34.67% of the vote, Marshall Orson receiving 41.35% of the vote, and Michelle Longspears receiving 23.98% of the vote. In Georgia, if one candidate doesn't get above 50% of the vote total, a runoff election is automatically held between the two top candidates, meaning Michelle Longspears was cut out of the race. But Michelle Longspears felt odd about the numbers, so she visited different precincts to double-check the tallies. Guess what? She noticed that in some precincts she didn't receive a single vote. But how is that possible that a candidate with 24% of the vote total finds precincts where she didn't receive a single vote? While statistically alarming, the real surprise came when she realized there was not one vote cast for her in her own precinct, the same one where she and her husband voted for herself.
Was not one vote cast for her in her own precinct, the same one where she and her husband voted for herself.
Spears immediately demanded a hand recount of the results and got one. On June 1st, the results were released, and the difference between the Dominion machine count and the hand count was shocking. After the hand count, Lauren Alexander gained 355 votes, Orson lost 1,298 votes, and Spears actually gained 3,620 votes, making her the new runoff candidate. And here's the best part. When you add them all up, the hand count shows 2,810 votes more than the Dominion machines reported on the 24th.
Virginia just stopped using touchscreen computer voting because it's so vulnerable.
Right.
We need to look at all the voting machines. Every Secretary of State needs to be, you know, assisted in making sure that they are not being hacked and attacked.
I continue to think that our voting machines are too vulnerable.
Our researchers have repeatedly demonstrated that ballot recording machines and other voting systems are susceptible to tampering.
Even hackers with limited prior knowledge, tools, and resources are able to breach voting machines in a matter of minutes.
In 2018, electronic voting machines in Georgia and Texas deleted votes for certain candidates or switched votes from one candidate to another.
The biggest seller of voting machines is doing something that violates Cybersecurity 101, directing that you install remote access software, which would make a machine like that, you know, a magnet for fraudsters and hackers.
These voting machines can be hacked quite easily.
You could easily hack into them. It makes it seem like all these states are doing different things, but in fact, three companies are controlling them.
It is the individual voting machines that pose some of the greatest risks.
There are a lot of states that are dealing with antiquated machines, right, which are vulnerable to being hacked.
Workers were able to easily hack into an electronic voting machine. It was possible to switch votes.
43% of American voters use voting machines that researchers have found have serious security flaws.
Former elected Mesa County clerk and recorder official that was in charge of elections, and I didn't believe that in my county, because it's a small county, that there was anything wrong with the 2020 election. I thought that there was probably things going on across the country, but we're a pretty conservative area. It wasn't until the 2021 municipal election, a local city council election, where when I pulled the results that night to present them to the public, I said, there's no way these people won. And I ended up doing a forensic image to back up election records before and after the Secretary of State and Dominion Voting Systems were coming in to do what they called a trusted build, Emma, you know. And isn't that funny that they would have such a trusting name,
right,
called the trusted build for something that was so nefarious? But what we found out,
right,
shocked the right up to the top of the administration, the Biden administration. Merrick Garland came down on our little town, the Secretary of State, the DA, and they started persecuting me and prosecuting. This happened in August of 2021. Mm-hmm. I'm now facing 7 felonies and 3 misdemeanor trial February 7th, just a short few weeks from now. Mm-hmm. What we exposed was,
right,
that they deleted 29,000 vital election records that prove how you get to the total. There were 36 wireless devices in the machines,
mm-hmm,
and the ability and software to actually flip votes. And they found CCP components in the election machines. We know that that they are ordered with those components in them from the CCP. And so we know that China has a big influence on our elections here in the U.S. And so we know that China has a big influence on our elections here in the U.S.
Check this out. This is a little segment from Dave's X22 report today. It's from Jen the Matrix, has this video he posted looking at CNN and the votes adjusting in real time. It goes by real fast, but he slows it down for us. Check it out.
773,948 votes. That ties to what the ribbon from CNN says. Same thing with Matt Bevin, 662,235. So here we go. Watch the gold. The update's coming. Boom, there it updates. And now here's this guy.
You see how?
Now let me show you what you missed. We're going to drag this back frame by frame. And so here we are before the update. And watch the gold. Here comes the update from Clarity. Boom. They haven't had a chance to update the ribbon because this is in split seconds we're looking at.
I'm not good with math.
So, Andy Beshear.
Is that 500 switch?
Here has just gained 560 votes. That makes sense. That's what happens as more votes come in, right? Let's look at Matt Bevin. He now has 661,675. But look down below. He did have 662,235.
That is just the same amount. And this is a great way of vote cheating, because in this situation, it's actually then becomes a 1,000-point difference. They could do this over and over again across the country. It's fractional voting. It's a great explanation
of this Dell, and I'm not saying it's there, but the concern is it might be there, is a socket designed for a wireless modem to be plugged in on the motherboard, okay, not on an add-in card. And it specifically has an Intel technology called AMT, which allows for out-of-band administration of the computer. What that means by out-of-band is the operating system doesn't even know that you're on the computer and you're changing things. The idea is if the Windows is busted, a remote administrator can come in, fix some drivers, and make the machine work again without actually having to come from a distance away, which is a great feature if you're an IT guy in our time. It's a great feature if you're administrating computers spread all over the place. On the other hand, it should never be in an election.
I'm Bev Harris. I'm the author of the book Black Box Voting. Now, in 2003, I found about 40,000 voting machine files. Among these files were the secret programs for the GEMS central tabulator, the central server, the master computer that controls what goes into every voting machine and what comes out of them. A couple years back, I shared these files with a Memphis programmer named Benny Smith, and he has found what I would characterize as a master key to the GEMS master computers.
So I wanted to get back to this fraction magic example. So this computer programmer in Memphis, Benny Smith, created what he calls, you know, a program called Fraction Magic. The reason it's called Fraction Magic is because the GEM system allows what I explained before, which is you to assign percentages or weights to people in certain races based on whatever values you ascribe to them, whether it's landowners or and such. What you wind up with is the ability for the system to deal with percentages, to deal with fractions. Now, obviously, on its face, dealing with my vote as a fraction sounds absurd, but the way the system is set up is exactly that. And so here's a screenshot of an example. So a congressional race, Democratic primary, this candidate Cohen gets 63,000 votes, this other candidate Harrington, he gets 17,000 votes. Let's just assume these are the actual authentic results that come in to this particular county. Again, proof of concept, just kind of an example of how systems can be manipulated. That's the before. This is the after. What you'll see is the total number of votes hasn't changed, 80,000 votes. But you can manipulate it so that Harrington wins the election, basically takes Cohen's votes. So now Harrington has 64,000 votes, and Cohen kind of has the inverse. He's got 16,000 votes. The key here is that the total vote number doesn't change. And these are shown in percentages, but you can do them in whole numbers. It's a math program, so you can give it any parameters that you want. But this is a really significant thing, because if you can give a computer program that's as valuable as the GEMS program a very simple instruction to say, give Harrington 80% of the votes and give Cohen 20%. That's all this program is telling it to do. And what this proof of concept shows is that those types of inputs shouldn't be allowed. The program should just block those kinds of things by default. But one of the things we discovered in reporting on this issue is that this stuff is really, really old. I mean, these GEM systems are 15, 20 years old, and in technology, that's generations beyond what they should be. But these things cost money. So you're left with, kind of old systems that allow these really funky, insecure, kind of dangerous things.
Ready?
Take. My name is Benny Smith, and I'm born and raised in Memphis, Tennessee.
I found something that it reeked when I first found it. But then the intrigue made me say, well, why is it there? Votes being counted as money.
16,034 votes and 0.31.
Oh, wait a minute.
You can divide them.
So the master computer can divide whole votes up into fractions. And we'll see what that can do to an election. Right now, the GEMS program is installed and counting votes in 25 states and 616 jurisdictions. But fractional counting began to migrate from the GEMS program into other vendors. Voting systems which count votes as fractions may count as many as 99% of all American votes in 2016. There are two screens you're going to see, which are the overlay that Benny Smith developed, which would be invisible when Fraction Magic is running. The first one looks like this to enter a password to access Fraction Magic. And the other one looks like this. It retrieves information from whatever county it's in so that the user can input their desired percents.
It brings up this form, and here is where the magic happens.
It then injects those percents automatically into the election results. Everything else is the actual GEM system, and the overlay that Benny developed simply uses what's already in the system. So what the heck did we just see? Let's break it down. Let's start with this. You probably noticed there were some big, fat, glaring decimals in the results shown in Benny's magic show. So I asked him about that.
I need the presence of these to effectively manipulate this.
You need to have it fractionalized.
Yes.
Now, does it need to show that?
No, I just chose to show it.
So the default setting, when you get the reports, it hides all the decimals.
And now we don't see that 0.31 anymore.
Oh, so if I'm looking at this, I have no idea that you just changed everything.
And that's the purpose of showing side by side that I know that it's 16034.31, but on here it is rounded.
And I can go into multiple counties in one. I've never been there, never seen what it looks like. I'm latching on to Alaska, and now it's coming in.
Fine, so you can go to any place.
Any place.
And it's gonna know who's running and what the races are.
Yes, if I jump out of here and go to Marin County.
That's in California.
California, Boston. Yeah, there's Boston. She's running against a guy named Mickey.
You're not reprogramming these counties.
No, I'm implementing them.
You're using what's already there.
Yes.
So this is basically one size fits all. You can be one person, and you can be entering different places, different states, gain total control.
Yes.
My fruit is better than gold, yea, than fine gold, and my revenue than choice silver. I lead in the way of righteousness in the midst of the paths of judgment, that I may cause those that love me to inherit substance, and I will fill their treasures. The Lord possessed me in the beginning of his way, before his works of old. I was set up from everlasting, from the beginning, or ever the earth was. When there were no depths, I was brought forth, when there were no fountains abounding with water. Before the mountains were settled, before the hills was I brought forth, while as yet he had not made the earth, nor the fields, nor the highest part of the dust of the world. When he prepared the heavens, I was there. When he set a compass upon the face of the depth, when he established the clouds above, when he strengthened the fountains of the deep, when he gave to the sea his decree that the water should not pass his commandment, when he appointed the foundations of the earth, then I was by him as one brought up with him. And I was daily his delight, rejoicing always before him, rejoicing in the habitable part of his earth. And my delights were with the sons of men. Now therefore hearken unto me, O ye children, for blessed are they that keep my ways. Hear instruction, and be wise, and refuse it not. Blessed is the man that heareth me, watching daily at my gates, waiting at the posts of my doors. For whoso findeth me, findeth life, and shall obtain favor of the Lord. But he that sinneth against me wrongeth his own soul. All they that hate me love death.